Hello everyone, welcome back to Kimets. In the last class, we have already discussed water pollution by sewage, industrial effluents and soaps and detergents. Today, we are discussing about water pollution by pesticides, fertilizers and heavy metals. Firstly, we can discuss water pollution by pesticides. Then, what do you mean by pesticides? Pesticides are the substances that are meant to control pests. There are different types of pesticides. Algicides which control algae, bactericides which control bacteria, fungicides which control fungi, herbicides which control plants, insecticides which control insects, rodenticides which control rodents, and so on. This classification is based on the target organism. The example for pesticides are DDT, lindane, malathion, parathion, chlordane, bagan, etc. Then, how will these pesticides enter into our water bodies? It is by a number of ways, such as by agricultural runoff, deposition from air, and by direct sprays on water surface to kill mosquitoes and other pests. Once they enter into the aquatic ecosystem, they concentrate in all components of the system. They remain in water persistently in soluble or suspended form or get absorbed on the surface of the silt and organic particles which sediment. From there, they enter into the food chain through bacteria, phytoplankton, other aquatic organisms and so on. By the process of biomagnification, the concentration of pesticide residues increases on moving up in the food chain. In organisms placed at the end of the food chain like fish, aquatic birds and man, they are liable to accumulate in a very high concentration. These are highly toxic and lethal to all types of living organisms including animals and plants. They kill and destroy all organisms. That is, one of the major adverse effects of water pollution by pesticides is that pesticides are persistent pollutant. Also, they undergo bioaccumulation and biomagnification. In humans, pesticide residues persist in various parts of the body. Mainly, pesticides are classified into four types according to chemical structure. These are carbamates, organophosphates, pyrethroids and chlorinated hydrocarbons. Here, the chlorinated hydrocarbons affect the central nervous system while others affect the circulatory or reproductive system. They accumulate persistently in various parts of the body and exert their toxic influence. They can cause cancers, hypertension, sterility, damage to kidney and death at higher concentration. Do you know what are the toxic effects created by pesticides on humans? Firstly, the excessive concentrations of chlorinated hydrocarbon pesticides in human tissues cause hormonal imbalance, cancer of the organs, leukemia, etc. The organophosphate pesticides interfere with the transmission of nerve impulses, causing unconditioned tremors, spasms, convulsions, and paralysis. Then, pesticides inhibit production and functioning of sex hormones, leading to sterility. Higher concentration of pesticides in pregnant women may result in abortions, stillbirths, and infant deformities. Pesticides cause hypertension and damage to kidneys. In higher concentration, they cause death. Pesticides exert their toxicity on microorganisms, aquatic organisms, plants, animals, and birds as well, causing death and destruction. Several types of fish, crabs, fish-eating birds, etc. have been wiped out or their population decreased in various regions of the earth on account of pesticide pollution. We are well known about the endosulfan disaster in Kerala. It is a pesticide pollution that had resulted from the spraying of endosulfan in the cashew plantations of Kasaragod, Kerala from 1978 to 2001. Endosulfan is a highly toxic organochlorine pesticide. It has caused various diseases and endless human sufferings. The effects suffered by the victims include mental retardation, physical deformities, cancers, birth disorders, infertility, cerebral palsy, epilepsy, and damages to the brain and nervous system. It also destroys the biodiversity of the area. Even though pesticides protect or increase yields, but Pesticides are potentially toxic to humans and can have both acute and chronic health effects depending on the quantity and the ways in which a person is exposed. So, instead of using chemical pesticides, we can use biopesticides. Next, we can discuss about water pollution by fertilizers. What do you mean by a fertilizer? A fertilizer is any material of natural or synthetic origin that is applied to the soil or to plant tissues to supply one or more plant nutrients essential to the growth of plants. Modern methods of agriculture since the so-called Green Revolution use immense quantities of nitrogenous, phosphatic and potash fertilizers. In most cases, a large excess of fertilizer than needed is being added to the fields. As a result, a large quantity of these are carried from the fields by agricultural runoff water into freshwater bodies, causing pollution problems. Contamination of water by fertilizer lead to very undesirable effects. Mainly, there are two adverse effects are created by fertilizers. One is eutrophication. We have already learned about eutrophication. In a large measure, fertilizer contamination of water results from the phosphate and nitrate ions present in fertilizer. This makes freshwater bodies nutrient rich. This favors massive algal growth. Such algal bloom in a water body cover the water surface and reduce the oxygen concentration in water. Such depletion of dissolved oxygen tend to choke out other forms of aquatic life, making it a dead pool of water. That is, the bloom-infested water inhibits the growth of other living aquatic organisms as well as causes their death. The anaerobic condition created causes profuse accumulation of foul-smelling decay products. Thus, fertilizer pollution of water leads to what is called eutrophication. Then what do you mean by eutrophication? It is a process in which nutrient-enriched water bodies support a dense plant population that kills animal life by depriving it of oxygen and lead to subsequent loss of biodiversity. Then what are the adverse effects caused by eutrophication? It leads to depletion of dissolved oxygen and then to destruction of aquatic organisms. Another important adverse effect of water pollution by fertilizer is blue baby syndrome. When water polluted with a nitrate is consumed by humans, nitrates are reduced to nitrite by intestinal bacteria. Nitrates cause serious child disease, methemoglobin anemia or blue baby syndrome, in which nitrate interfere with the oxygen carrying capacity of blood, causing suffocation as well as damage to respiratory and vascular system. Blue baby syndrome is characterized by an overall skin color with a blue or purple tinge. This bluish appearance is most noticeable where the skin is thin, such as the lips, earlobes, and nail beds. The baby takes on a bluish hue because of poorly oxygenated blood. Normally, blood is pumped from the heart to the lungs where it receives oxygen. The blood is circulated back through heart and then throughout the body. When there is a presence of nitrites, the hemoglobin combines with a nitrate, not with oxygen. This is the reason for the poorly oxygenated blood. Then, how will you control water pollution by fertilizer? Control of water pollution by fertilizers can be achieved by the use of biofertilizers. This involves the use of efficient strains of microorganisms like rhizobium, azospirillum, azobacter, etc. or blue-green algae capable of converting atmospheric nitrogen into nitrate, or those like PSM capable of solubilizing phosphorus from the fixed form. They are cheaper, renewable and pollution-free. Due to a lack of proper education to the farmers and a lack of proper marketing and distribution methods, biofertilizers are not much used nowadays, but this may replace the chemical fertilizers in future. The next topic is water pollution by heavy metals. Then, what do you mean by heavy metals? Heavy metals are generally defined as metals with relatively high densities, atomic weight or atomic numbers. Some heavy metals are either essential nutrients, for example iron, cobalt, zinc, or relatively harmless, such as ruthenium, silver and indium, but can be toxic in large amounts or certain forms. Other heavy metals such as cadmium, mercury, lead are highly poisonous. The substantial pollution by heavy metals is caused by the discharge of effluents from mining and ore processing, metal plating, chemical, paint, leather, and a host of other industries. Heavy metals are discharged into water by domestic sewage, agricultural runoff, water from corroded metal plates, etc. The main sources of heavy metals include fossil fuel combustion, municipal waste disposal, fertilizers and pesticides, metallurgical industries, industrial activities, smelting and mining of ores. Now we can discuss the adverse effects of heavy metals one by one. Firstly, lead. Lead pollution of natural water is caused by effluents from a large number of industries such as petroleum, paint, ceramics, battery, and plastics, burning of leaded gasoline, use of pesticide, lead arsenates, etc. Lead is highly toxic to all living organisms. Lead affects aquatic organisms even in very small concentration. In animals and man, lead accumulates mainly in the bones, from where it comes into circulation in the body, particularly at the time of stress and illness. Lead interacts with the SH group in proteins and enzymes, causing their denaturation. This leads to the breakdown of several enzyme systems. Lead causes anemia, disruption of hemoglobin synthesis, as well as damage to kidneys, liver, reproductive system, and brain. It interferes with the development of nervous system, and thus its toxicity is more acute in children than in adults. It affects the intellectual development of infants and children, causing potentially permanent behavioral disorders. Adverse health effects associated with exposure to high levels of lead include vomiting, diarrhea, convulsions, coma, and even death. Next, we can discuss about mercury water pollution. The effluents from various industries such as electrochemical industry and those manufacturing batteries, caustic soda, mercury vapor lamp, etc., and effluents from metallurgical operations introduce substantial amounts of mercury into water. Then, what are the adverse effects of mercury water pollution? Mercury is highly toxic to all aquatic as well as terrestrial organisms. It has a tremendous capacity to bioaccumulate in the form of methyl mercury. It further tends to biomagnify through food chain, ultimately causing brain damage in consumers at higher trophic level. This was evidenced when many normally fish-eating peoples of the Minamata city of Japan died and several were paralyzed in 1956 to 1960 by the so-called Minamata disease. The Minamata disease is a neurological syndrome resulting in irreversible brain damage caused by severe mercury poisoning. The initial symptoms of the disease include ataxia, that is the lack of voluntary coordination of the muscle movements, general muscle weakness, numbness in the hands and feet, difficulty in walking, convulsions, loss of peripheral vision, and damage to speech and hearing. Insanity, paralysis, coma, and death follow within weeks of the onset of symptoms. The disease was first discovered in the Minamata city of Japan in 1956 and thus got its name. Its symptoms were first observed in cats, which were found to be jumping uncontrollably through repeated spasms, and hence the disease also got the name dancing cat fever. The disease was caused by the methyl mercury present in the effluents discharged into the Minamata Bay from the Chiso Corporation's vinyl chloride plant called Minamata Chemical Plant situated there. In the incidence of the disease at Minamata, which resulted from people eating mercury-contaminated fish, more than 100 people lost their lives immediately and many thousands were permanently paralyzed. Around 50 babies born during that period were found to have genetic defects as their mothers had consumed the mercury-contaminated fish from the bay during pregnancy. The incident came to be known as the Minamata disaster, and its death toll continued to rise over the years, and it is officially recognized that 1,784 people have actually died from the disease. Another tragic incident through mercury poisoning is one which took place in Iraq in 1972, where around 450 villagers died after eating wheat that had been dusted with a mercury-containing pesticide. Next, we can discuss about cadmium water pollution. Cadmium is introduced into natural waters through effluents from electroplating, paint, ink, plastics, etc. industries, and from gold jewelry works. Like mercury, cadmium also undergoes biomagnification through food chains, reaching its maximum level in man. Cadmium persistently accumulates in liver, kidney, pancreas and thyroid in humans. At high levels, it causes damage to lungs, kidney, etc. and cause anemia and bone marrow depression. A typical example of cadmium poisoning in the past was the outbreak of itai-itai or ouch-ouch disease. So named to indicate the terrible pain associated with it in the Jinzu River Basin in Japan. The disease made bone fragile. Thousands of people died through microfracture of bones and thousands were affected by this bone disease. The disease was caused by the consumption of cadmium ingested rice from the fields irrigated using water from the Jinzu River. The river was contaminated with cadmium by drainage water from the surrounding mines. Next, we can discuss about chromium water pollution. Natural waters gets polluted with chromium by effluents from metal plating industries, leather tanning industry, cement industry, dye industry, pigment industry, etc. Then what are the effects of chromium pollution? It is toxic to aquatic and terrestrial organisms. In humans, it causes skin and respiratory disorders and respiratory tract cancer. Next, we can discuss about arsenic water pollution. Arsenic have two types of sources, natural sources and anthropogenic sources. The natural sources includes forest fire, rock weathering, volcanoes, etc. The anthropogenic sources or man-made sources include industrial emission and runoff, fertilizers and pesticides, etc. Mainly, arsenic pollute water bodies through pesticides, chemical waste and effluents from mining industries. An example for arsenic pesticide is lead arsenate. It is highly toxic to all types of organisms. It inhibits the action of enzymes which catalyze cellular reactions. It causes cancer on accumulation at lower levels. It kills at high levels of concentration of arsenic. Today we discussed about water pollution by pesticides, fertilizers and heavy metals. In the next video, we will discuss about water pollution control measures. Thank you.